Some people don't know when to quit. Chuck Wepner was one of these people. Wepner was famous for two things as a heavyweight boxer in the 1970s, having his face broken open, his nickname was the Bleeder, and going 15 rounds with Muhammad Ali in a title match for the championship. Ali, not surprisingly, beat the living daylights out of Wepner. On a world record list of tolerating senseless brutalization for far too long without admitting defeat or changing tactics, Wepner ranks high. On a list of successes, not so much. Much the same could be said of the Mercedes-Benz Urban Mobility subsidiary known as Smart. The company has spent almost 10 years in the American market now, building and attempting to sell an unerringly similar recipe of small, uncomfortable, homely, cheap, uninspired, inefficient, overpriced, subpar, fun-colored, rear-engine city vehicles, and has not gained an iota of traction. With all of the power and glory of the three-pointed star behind it, the brand last year ranked in the bottom three of total sales, just above Alfa Romeo, which had no cars to sell, and Bentley, which prides itself on selling as few cars as possible. Sales for 2016 were down 17%. They're down nearly 20% more from there thus far in 2017. Alfa Romeo has sold more cars. Yet, instead of giving up and going away, the brand has decided to stick around for a few more rounds. One would think that this might demonstrate a willingness to learn from its big mistakes, which include making cars that are worse than anything in or around by their price or size segment, including a lot of great cars like the Honda Fit and Ford Fiesta. And Smart's big move, an announcement that, starting in 2018, it will sell only pure electric vehicles in the States, indicates some sense of prescience and topicality. The EV market is maturing and growing, moving out from early adopters to fast followers and perhaps even beginning to trickle down into the mainstream, so the time seems ripe to jump on the bandwagon. And Mercedes is investing heavily in electric power, planning to develop a full range of vehicles under its XUV brand, so Smart can clearly capitalize on some of that know-how. Unfortunately, after having spent an afternoon in Switzerland test driving the first of these vehicles to be released in America, the 2017 Smart Ford One Electric Drive Cabrio, we can attest to the fact that the brand has not learned anything, but simply converted their previous losing formula to run on electricity. Yet, instead of giving up and going away, the brand has decided to stick around for a few more rounds. One would think that this might demonstrate a willingness to learn from its big mistakes, which include making cars that are worse than anything in or around by their price or size segment, including a lot of great cars like the Honda Fit and Ford Fiesta. And Smart's big move, an announcement that, starting in 2018, it will sell only pure electric vehicles in the States, indicates some sense of prescience and topicality. The EV market is maturing and growing, moving out from early adopters to fast followers and perhaps even beginning to trickle down into the mainstream, so the time seems ripe to jump on the bandwagon. And Mercedes is investing heavily in electric power, planning to develop a full